Good morning, everyone. This is Lance. I have some great news that I wanted to tell you about this morning. We are looking forward to our in-person reopening next week, June 21st, on Father's Day. A little bit about the guiding principles that have got us to this point. We have desperately been wanting to get together again, as you all have, but we've also wanted to temper that with wisdom and make sure that we did as much research as we could. So we've been following what the CDC has been saying, what Orange County Public Health has been saying, and we've done our very best to try to get our facility ready for you. And we believe that we are ready. So we will be opening for live services next week. So if you find yourself in a low-risk category with no underlying health conditions that might compromise your safety, if you have kids that can sit with you the whole time, then we invite you to come and join us live in person for our grand opening, grand reopening next Sunday, June 21st. A little bit about some of the things that you can expect when you arrive, because there are some things that are going to be a little bit different. Before you arrive, we're going to have the entire foyer, restrooms, and sanctuary wiped down with a CDC-approved sanitizer. When you do arrive, you will see that we will be observing social distancing. There will be some placards on the ground that just help remind us to give people their distance. And we are going to be asking people to wear masks. We will have some masks, disposable ones, that will be given to you if you should forget yours. So come on, we've got you covered. We will also have our greeters will be out there with touchless thermometers just for everyone's safety. We'll have hand sanitizing stations located in the foyer, so feel free to use those as you need. Bulletins will be laid out for you on the counter, and we're going to try to keep the restrooms limited to about 3 people at a time, the larger restrooms. So please help police that on your own. We're not going to have a restroom monitor or anything, but just do your best to give everyone the space that they need to feel comfortable and safe. At first, we're not going to be having any refreshments and coffee, but we are working toward a plan of bringing back coffee first, hopefully in July. Jane's working on that for us, so thank you, Jane. We'll also have some one-way directional signage on the ground to sort of help us in our hallways. Our hallways are a little bit narrow, so for example, as you go off to the restrooms, there will be one-way signs directing you to go inside to the restrooms and then outside, enjoying the nice weather on the way back through the foyer as you come back from the restrooms. You'll notice in the sanctuary, the seating will be greatly spaced out to take advantage of the 6-foot rule. And so you'll see chairs grouped in 2s, 3s, and 4s. Feel free to move them around as you need. We'll have about 40 or 50 chairs set up initially, which should take care of our needs at the beginning. But just feel free to move the chairs around as you need to be able to sit with your household groups and give space to other household groups. Just a reminder, children's Sunday school classes will be closed at least for the next little while. So children who can sit with parents the whole time, they're invited to come and participate in the service. Parents, you know, if that just doesn't work for you, hang on there a little bit longer. Believe me, we want to get you in here as fast as we can. Also, in conformance with CDC guidelines, they've recommended that we not pass offering plates or communion plates. So for our offering, Pastor Mark has built some great offering boxes that we're going to have at the entry and exit of our sanctuary. Please feel free to use those as you come and go to place your offerings or welcome cards. For communion, we will continue to be taking communion on the first Sunday of the month. We've ordered some prepackaged communion cups that are sanitized and will be set out for you before the services begin. As far as the worship experience, the musical worship, we're going to be running on sort of a minimal band to maximize our space up on the stage, and the first row of chairs will be set about 10 feet from the band members. The front row singers will not be wearing masks because that would be probably weird and distracting because of the sound change. For those of you who are in the congregation, we'd encourage you to keep your masks on. Sing loud, sing soft, close your eyes and sort of let the spirit move as we sing together. If you're not comfortable singing, that's fine. But we just encourage you to come and participate. You'll notice that our tech crews have acrylic isolation booths as best we could sort of set up. And so those will be kind of fun to look at. but please feel free to give them their space so that they can feel safe. We will be piping in Seth over video. He's going to be preaching from home for a number of reasons for the foreseeable future. And then we'll hopefully have him back in the building soon. As our services conclude, please feel free to go ahead and move outside for visiting. We're going to need to wipe down the sanctuary for the next group that's coming in. So go outside and visit in a way that you feel safe. Keep your masks on, but give your people 6 feet of space and just fellowship together. But do that outside, please. Our tenant churches are coming in after us, so we just want to make sure that we have time to wipe down the sanctuary and the foyer for them. For those of you who are waiting a little longer, we totally understand. God bless you. We want to get you in here as soon as we can, but please wait until you feel well and safe and are ready to come back. We'll also have a little bit more for you over the next couple of weeks about small groups. We'd like to get those meeting again in person, but we'd like to talk to our small group leaders and kind of find out what's going on first. So that's it for this Sunday. God bless you, and we will see you next week, those of you who can come. Take care.